about us, we see the bitter and abundant harvest from permissiveness. Something has gone radically wrong with secularism. The problem has more than its share of irony, for secularism, in the end, has converted itself into a kind of religion. And now the transition is complete. The state has become the church. The more what is politically correct seeks to replace what God has declared correct, the more ineffective approaches to human problems there will be. I have no hesitancy in stating, brothers and sisters, that unless checked, permissiveness, by the end of its journey, will cause humanity to stare in mute disbelief at its awful consequences. Church members will live in this wheat and tares situation until the millennium. Some real tares even masquerade as wheat, including the few eager individuals who lecture the rest of us about church doctrines in which they no longer believe. They criticize the use of church resources to which they no longer contribute. They condescendingly seek to counsel a brethren whom they no longer sustain. Confronted, except of themselves, of course, they leave the church, but they cannot leave the church alone. Like the throng on the ramparts of the great and spacious building, they are intensely and busily preoccupied, pointing fingers of scorn at the steadfast iron rotters. Perhaps in their mockings, beneath the stir, are repressed doubts of their doubts. In any case, given the perils of popularity, Brigham Young advised that this people must be kept where the finger of scorn can be pointed at them. Therefore, brothers and sisters, quiet goodness must persevere, even when, as prophesied, a few actually rage in their anger against that which is good. Likewise, the arrogance of critics must be met by the meekness and articulateness of believers. If sometimes ringed by resentment, we must still reach out, especially for those whose hands hang down. If our shortcomings as a people are occasionally highlighted, then let us strive to do better.